In 2006, the State Department of Transportation was awarded a $1.4 million harbor security grant from the federal government to install high-tech security measures at Honolulu Harbor, where more than 90% of the state's merchandise arrives every year. $75,000 of that money went to purchase this unmanned aerial vehicle, known as a UAV or a drone, which arrived here last June. It's supposed to be used to transmit aerial video of harbor facilities, but the craft has never left the ground and sits here in a state DOT office 9 months later.
Unfortunately, we never ever checked with the FAA if we could fly a UAV around Honolulu Harbor, and we cannot.
State Transportation spokesman Dan Meisenzahl says the state cannot fly the drone at the harbor because it's too close to Honolulu International Airport.
But it's an international airport, so there's a restricted area around the airport, and Honolulu Harbor is a part of that restricted area.
The state DOT Harbors Division hopes to enter a partnership with another state or county agency that could use the drone for surveillance.
We're not going to let it sit here in a room for the next 20 years. You know, we're going to do something about this. We're going to rectify the situation, and that's one of the things that we're definitely working on right now in the Harbors Division.
Or, he says, in the worst-case scenario, the state could sell the drone to another agency.
We might have to sell it, and if that's the case, we'll be able to recoup the cost.
While Meisenzahl admits the state made a $75,000 mistake with the drone, he says the rest of the federal grant went to install video surveillance of Honolulu Harbor, Kiwalo Basin, and Kalaeloa Harbor.
That $1.4 million, I would argue the vast majority of it has been well spent and has been put to great use every day.